to get your next shirt or go to the concert. If I meet the Misfits, I'm gonna be like, dude, this guy, he sat down the whole fucking time. You know? Or if I meet Danzig, I mean, I'm sure you like him too. Now it's really quiet. So don't feel bad because people are laughing at me more silently. See? When you're a band, you have to wait for the sound guy to be done before that you could start playing. So in the meantime,
I'm done.
I love your whole vibe. He's just like, I'm done. You're just fucking up now. All right. So if everybody comes a little bit closer, because I'm creepy and needy and lonely. Especially, I just want to hug the yellow shirt man. He's the coolest motherfucker in here. He is. All right, now I'm going to ask everybody how they're doing, except for you and you guys. I'm not even asking you. This question is not towards you guys. No, it is, and I hope to win you all over. I hope to win your hearts. I do. So listen, this question I ask is, how's everybody doing? And you guys go,
swell.
Yeah, you've been to a concert, right? But how about we pretend that there's 8,000 people in here and you guys are much louder. So I say, how's everybody doing? And you say, okay, but when we do this for real, it's gotta be like 10 times louder than that. All right? We're gonna do it for real this time. John, are you ready?
Yeah.
I'm not gonna make it go until you're ready. You ready? All right. This is for real this time. And we're gonna go and play the show and it's gonna be crazy and everything's gonna be good. All right?
what they find underneath your sign. Uh-oh.
John, like, pretty good at the drums, though. It's about fun, but lately it's important because I started talking to my dad again on the internet, and I wrote that song, believe it or not. My dad will never see me play, unless we get famous, so if you guys can help us out with that, that'd be cool. But my dad was like a con man and a diamond smuggler and a couple other really fun things from movies, but he's banned from America, so he can't ever come back to anybody anywhere affiliated with America, or, you know, any American state, or anywhere to see me play. So the only way I could ever play in front of him would be to basically get big enough to go overseas in a country where America's not their friend, which there's not a lot of them that you play shows at. So, Russia, I'm sure people will be down in Russia. A couple bucks, it's like $15 to get to Russia. So I wrote a song, and it's basically, it was a letter to him. He's a charismatic guy. I wouldn't be able to talk as much shit as I'm able to talk if he didn't teach me how. But he left when I was 10 years old, so I wrote that song to him. So I'm really glad that you guys all sing it, because you don't know what a big deal that is to me. Because it's like a big old fucking hug. That's a traumatic part of my life, and writing that song really helped me get through it. So thank you guys for singing it with me. And this is a new song. It's called Winners in the Sun. And the point of this song is that I don't think it's right the way that corporations fuck over most people in the world. So I wrote a song about how they do that to everybody. It's called Winners in the Sun. We'll be right back. away. Everybody.
All the things that the people say. All the things that the people say. The people say. The people say. All the things that the people say.
Have you ever had a daydream linking to your day? Have you ever had a nightmare thinking that everybody ever had a thought that you know will go away? Have you ever had a nightmare?
When I cry.
Thank you. I know I'm not the smartest fellow, and I'm not somebody to look up to, and I'm not somebody who has any political answers, but it is shitty the way that corporations do things to human beings, but then aren't held accountable as human beings. So I decided to write a song about that, even though it's not going to become very popular because radio doesn't like to play shit like that. But thank you guys so much for listening to it. This next song is called Now I Won't Go. My monitor? Can anybody guess what that song is about?
Addiction.
It's about being addicted. It's about being addicted to many, many things. Not drugs, not just that, but
sex.
I don't know.
Sex!
I don't know what that's like. I wish I did, to be honest with you. Anything though, because I feel like growing up the way we all grow up in the country that we all grow up in, we're kind of sold this idea that we're not supposed to be happy with ourselves ever and constantly need to search for something to make us happy. So I kind of wrote a song just about addiction in general and how everybody has it. It's just not drugs or women or, for you apparently, sex. This guy's dick's about to fall off.
I'm addicted to brick and mortar.
You're addicted to brick and mortar. I'm sorry for you. But yeah, no, I like to try to write songs that make people feel like, oh, hey, I'm not fucking crazy. Because it's true. So this next song I'm about to play is called Terrible Things, and it's about being depressed. And realizing that, you know, everybody's depressed sometimes, and you're supposed to be depressed. If you're fucking happy all the time, you're a clown, and that's fucking weird. You know what I'm saying? And I feel like people don't have anyone to talk to. And growing up, I didn't have anybody to talk to when I was upset and I didn't come from a good home and things like that. So I wrote a song about the fact that everybody feels really, really terrible and thinks about doing really terrible things. And the song is called Terrible Things. And hopefully you guys all see the positive in it and don't just think I'm fucking depressing and shit. The song is called Terrible Things.
I knew I shouldn't think it, but I knew anyway.
I'm sure you already know that.
Leslie, Leslie, thank you so much.
But I gotta reach out to my dudes back there. Do you hate me less? A little. Not good enough to get you up, but you hate me less. What about this table over here?
Definitely hate
me
less.
Definitely hate me less. Cool. Awesome. I like the honesty. Enjoy your root beer.
I think if you were drunk, it'd be easier.
This water is really extra wet. It's really hard. Honestly, growing up, I didn't even drink any alcohol until
this tour.
Until I got drunk. Until I got drunk before this tour, I didn't drink alcohol. And I'm like 29 now, so. I smoked lots of pot, though. And I did drink. And I did do various drugs at different times in my life, which I'm not ashamed of, because I'm responsible enough to not be homeless. Only thing, and you never have to say that at any other job. I come in and I'm like, yeah, I like the position. What are your qualifications? Well, I don't drink that much. I smoke a lot of pot. I've done all the drugs there are, except for the really bad ones. And I'm not homeless, so can I please work at your bank? They're like, no, I don't. I think you're a scumbag, but
there's nothing wrong.
What?
Words of wisdom.
Words of wisdom. I'm not very wise, but if you want to take that, you crazy sex addict, you do whatever you want. I'm bringing it back around. All right, stand up. I'm not even going to do the songs. I'm just going to talk shit. All
right, so this next song,
because I just like get off on telling you what my songs are about. This song is called Keep This Place Beautiful. And let me ask you guys a question. And every single crowd has gotten this wrong, and it makes me really sad. Who are the most important people in the world?
Not us.
We are.
No. Who are the most important people for the world? If you're talking about the greatest scheme of the fucking world, right? Who are the most important people who can change the world? Like, who's the most important people?
The Kardashians!
Okay, this is the problem, or the answer every time. Because everybody always says, a famous actor, or a, you know, sports star, or a person in a band, or children, but children aren't really anybody yet.
It's the future.
I mean, if you give a five-year-old is like a bunch of money and say change the world, they might just buy a bunch of fucking Lucky Charms and shit. You know, candy and whatnot. Alright, the real answer to this is, teachers, nurses, scientists, doctors, fucking, I don't know, archaeologists if you like dinosaurs. But, like, the point of this is that you're actually supposed to, you know, care about those people who can change the world for the better, not just the Kardashians because their booty's so fine. You know? Shh, Connie right here and have a problem with me. Yeezy will never make me. Kanye, you know what I mean?
Yeah!
But seriously, this song is about changing the world for the better before you die. Just one small way. So before everybody dies, for me, can you please just try to do one nice thing for the whole world? Just one thing. And then you can get fucked up and trash and do whatever you want, but just do one nice thing. Three people will do it. Everyone else is like, fuck that. I'm gonna get really messed up and I don't care. Alright, so this song is called Keep This Place Beautiful. Thank you for listening to me explain it.
Just
I'm an honest man. I fucked that song up a little bit, but you have it forever. Okay? I dropped my pick and I was like, brain fart. I'm fucking this up a little bit. But then I tried to finish strong for you guys.
Turn around.
It doesn't matter. Just turn around. Turn around with the camera. They got up from their seats. That's all I care about. So maybe I was meant to fuck that up for you guys. Thank you guys very much. We have a couple more songs for you. And then we have to get the fuck out of here and go to the next place. You guys all have nice houses to sleep at. I just have to stay at a bunch of hotels where I don't have to clean anything ever. It's terrible. Everybody asks me, they're like, oh, do you hate being on tour? Wouldn't you rather be home? I was like, are you asking bands that have nice homes? Or just everybody before like me? My house sucks. I'd much rather be in a hotel where they... He'll tell you, I'm fucking a slob. He's the opposite of me completely. Everything is clean, his section's all in order. He puts his clothes like in the drawers when we get to the hotel.
Only for every 3 days.
No, I'm just kidding. Alright,
well, we're gonna play the song called Locked in the Cage. And then we have one more song for you.
20 pounds.
No. 20 pounds. We don't have 20 pounds in the sampler, so I can't do it.
What?
And listen, I'm sorry. I got robbed. I'm sorry.
I helped you. No.
Listen.
Well, like
20 pounds. Yeah. You know what happens, though? You only have a certain amount of time that you could do it. When you're an opening band, no one cares about you.
Oh, we care.
You guys care, but the people who book you. Can you tell them how it works? When you're opening band, you only have a certain amount of time.
You guys to play another.
Sometimes I forget that we're at a show and
we
I'm just talking to you.
You that day.
I gotta tell you this much. If we were here, we can. I know that. But we don't have the samples. This is a really complicated conversation now. We've talked for a while. The point being is, it's not my fault that I didn't play it that time, and it's not my fault that I didn't play it this time.
Well, we encored you last time, and I asked you to play that.
I know, but I couldn't do it.
You could have.
I couldn't have.
Oh, that's time.
I could have. Listen, next time I'll play it because I'll mess it up. Alright?
Next time we come to.
Listen, I'm just a human being, man.
You
I need to do shit that I have practiced or I will fuck it up.
You just locked in the cage. You just locked in the cage.
I'm just. Good play on words, my man. He's just locked in the cage. He's locked in the cage of songs that he does that don't suck. It's a hard song, that song.
20 pounds does not suck.
No, it doesn't suck, but I suck when I suck at it. All these people, if I played a song really bad, would be like, you know what? Brick and Mortar was really good until they fucking sucked. And then it would be terrible.
I'll just chalk it up to you.
I owe you. Yeah. You know what? And we've had this moment, and like everybody heard us talking to each other for a long time.
You got this on tape, right?
Yeah, it's on tape.
Hey, Brandon. John's hair is great.
Hey, John's hair is great. Hold on, let's just talk about John for a minute. First of all, John's the shit. At the drums. Second of all, he's a bitch. Let me tell you why he's a bitch. Listen, let me tell you why he's a bitch. I love John.
You're a bitch.
Listen, let me tell him why. Because look, he used to have these insane like beard. Well, he like cut it like Wolverine chops, right?
Six chops.
And then I was like, Tega, why don't you do it? And we've been best friends since we were 14. So anything I say, he's like, fuck you. Because we've been best friends, so. I tell John, I say, hey, how about you wear those chops for this tour coming up? And because I ask, he's like, no fucking way. I'm wearing those chops. That's my choice. I'm like, well, John.
We were out at Denny's one night, and he told me to do the chops, and I got so mad at him.
Well, he got so mad. Let me tell you how mad he got. Let me tell you how mad, because I think he's going to deliver it a little bit differently than it happened.
He was just being an asshole.
We're at Denny's, it's 2 in the morning. I'm like, John, your chops, why don't you bring them back? He's like, don't tell me what to do. I ain't good chops. I'm like, come on, John, I keep the long hair because I looked really goofy when I was bald. You know, I'm doing it for the people. I hate my hair. No, I love my hair. I do. So John's looking at me and he's like, no, I'm not getting the chops. Stop telling me what to do. And I was like, I bet you people would like you more with the chops. I think everybody loved the Chops.
Yeah,
and then Feeney's like, my man Feeney, Dan Feeney back there, who was also our best friend, he's like, John, why don't you just get the Chops? Everybody likes the Chops. He's like, shut up! And then I start laughing. He's like, if you tell me one more time to get Chops, I'm gonna stab you in the eye with this fork. He said it at Denny's. Right as the lady's like coming up to get her order. And the point of the story is it was the worst Denny's we ever had. So
that's why I was so mad.
Not that there's any.
It was over my hand, it was fucking terrible.
Yeah. Well, you ordered like what a fucking grandma orders. I'll get the moon over Miami, please. And then Feeney's like, I'll have the eggs Benedict. I was like, you're at Denny's. It's no Denny's is good. Put that on the internet. Don't ever go to Denny's, they're all bad. Fuck the Grand Slam. Alright, we have to finish this show now. So we have two more songs, then we have to get out of here. This song is called Locked in a Cage. About no matter how completely fucked you are, and how much you think you're never ever gonna make it. And whatever you're doing, just keep going, because it's a lot funner to keep going and give the finger to everybody than it is to quit and then do whatever sad thing you fucking compromise to do. So this song is called Bangs, and it's about never, ever, ever giving up, even if the world is totally against you, and always doing the thing that you think is right. Because it's not always a fun thing to do what's right, but when you're an old fuck, if you're lucky enough to live that long, you'll be happy with yourself. So it's about not giving up and doing the right thing.